Good morning, students. I'm Himlata Patil, your SS teacher. Welcomes you all for this video lecture. Students, in your class 5, there is chapter number 13, communication. We are going to see in details. So what is communication? So let's see. So students, I'm asking you, what is the communication? Communication is the exchange of facts, ideas, opinions, and emotions between two or more people. So this communication is means of exchanging of our ideas, thoughts, feelings. Okay, so we can communicate when we talk to our friends either face to face or over the telephone. But now students, I want to ask you one question. Suppose you don't have any facilities of communicate. Okay, so how you will communicate with your friends? I think by beating drum, by some gestures, by signs, or fire or any noise. So like that earlier people were using. Now, but earlier messages were sent over long distance through pigeons, horses, or camels. But now, my dear students, there are so many facilities like our telephone, TV, telephone, fax, newspaper, phone, inland letters, and radio, so on, and etc. Now, how this happens? Because of invention, okay? Because our man is very intelligent and he invented for his purpose or his need, and he started to find out finer and finer communications. So these all are means of communication. Now these means of communication are divided into two parts. That is, one is personal communication and second one is mass communication. So what is personal communication? Personal communication is a communication that exchange of information between only two individuals. Okay, the various media of personal communication we are going to see. What are that? First one we are going to see, that is post office. Letters and parcels are sent and received through the post office, and whatever the cost is sending of a letter is made by buying postage stamps. Okay, these postage stamps were providing us information about the culture and history of a country. See here, our heroes, our social workers, our scientists, and so on, like that. So, you know, students, urgent letters, suppose if you want to send some urgent letter or message with the postage, it was not going. So for that, one was a speed post and another was courier. But there was another facility, that was telegraph. It was very short message, and this telegraph was the earliest means of communication, okay? And it was invented by Samuel Morse, okay? And in 1840, and it is the electric telegraph, and because of that, it was going earlier message, okay? Then afterwards, internet and email came, and smartphone came, and it went. Now, we will see the next one. That is telephone. So this telephone, do you know who has invented this telephone? That is first, this type of telephone was there, like this old, then this one, then this one. You must have seen this one. So who has invented this? The great man, Alexander Graham Bell. See here, how he has invented this one. So, now we can talk to a person in any part of the world over the telephone. there was the wired phones, okay, and that are called landline. We are calling it landline. So with the telephone we can, then afterwards it comes mobile phone. First mobile phone was invented by Martin Cooper in 1973. Then with the help of this we can send SMS. SMS means short message service, okay, and because of that we can connect anywhere. It can also be connected to the internet, okay. So it happens and it receives radio broadcast, play music and take picture. All that things we can do with the mobile phone. Now we will see that is now, but you know that this phone are afterwards cell phone created by 1971 in Henry T. Sampson, and our digital cell phone was invented Jesse E. Russell. Now we are going to see next. Next means that is fax, telefax. So we can send printed matter or pictures instantly through a fax machine. This telefax machine can send an exact copy of handwritten or printed material or picture to another person, but it works through the telephone lines. That's why we can call it telefax. Now another is email. Email means electronic mail. So this electronic mail is a system of sending and receiving message through a computer or by our mobile. It makes use of internet and delivers message instantly any corner of the world. Okay, so for that you need email account, email address, okay, and the receiver's address should be there. Now we have seen these all for the personal communication, but now you know that there is another part, that is mass communication. So what is mass communication? Mass communication is a means of communicating with a large number of people at the same time, like newspaper, magazines, books, radios, televisions and cinema. These all are mass communication. So let's see one by one. First we are going to see that is newspaper and magazines. These are the first means of mass communication. They are part of print area. Okay, newspaper and magazines bring us news from all over the world. Magazines and journals provide us on any topic, specific topics such as politics, sports, fashion, entertainment, environment and etc. All we can get the updates from the world through the newspaper. Now this newspaper invented printing press is Johannes Gutenberg. Now next topic is that radio. You know that, my dear students, this is very popular in rural area as well as urban area. See here how people are taking benefit. Now this is invented by G. Marconi. Okay, so and it is a source of entertainment as well as education. News and warning information about natural calamities are broadcasted on radio, and it is both literate and illiterate people benefit from it. So this is all about the radio. Have you seen this radio? It must be at your home. Now the next one, everybody knows this, that is television. Okay, so television is a most popular means of communication. So you know that who has invented this television? That is invented by John Logie Baird. Okay, this give that gives information communication to the whole new meaning. What we can see live or recorded any match, any program or any speech, budget, session, whatever it is we can see. And this happens because of communication satellites. See, these satellites were are giving information. See here, our whatever the our temperature, weather, that can show us. And with the help of communication satellites, we can see it at home and watch important events happening in any part of the world. See here, now we are going to see the internet, the most means of communication, most popular, that is the internet. Internet is the fastest means of communication in the world. It provides news and detailed information that can be used by people. Okay, email and all that, that facility is because of email, because of internet we can get. There are search engines. With the search engines, we can use the internet. They are Google, Yahoo, like that. These Google and Yahoo are the famous search engines. Okay, and these websites are that can be access anytime to keep ourselves updated. Now we can see the next, that is cinema. Now, you know, have you seen this cinema theater? Yes, but now because of corona, we are at home. These films are an important means of mass communication. They are a source of entertainment, education, and knowledge. Some documentary films are also made to spread information about our culture and environment, or some biographical also, we can get some information from that leaders also, how that leaders struggle and all that. This cinema also help us to understand better how the people of other countries, how they are thinking, how they are living, like that, all things we can get by cinema. Now, the next one, that is advertisement. These advertisements provide information about a particular product or service to the people. These advertisements we can see in the newspaper, magazine, television, anywhere we can get from holdings and all that. So these educate us about a new product or any new service, what they are available. Okay, and nowadays the internet is also used for advertisement. Advertisements are also used for spreading social awareness among the people. Now, you know, for example, about the corona, keep mask on your mouth, keep distance, again and again wash your hands. These all the safety rules they are telling. These are the advertisements that keeps us and that aware, making us that social awareness. Okay, that is spreading that this don't smoke, say no to tobacco, like this they were spreading spreading awareness, social awareness. So like this, all advertisements are also affects us for the mass communication. So these all, my dear students, these all communications. So my dear students, these all communications, means of communication, is for our betterment, for our future. So we should use it very carefully and safely. So be careful always. And have a nice day. Stay safe. Stay safe, stay at home. Thank you.